Despite being the biggest unofficial Star Wars YouTube channel, Star Wars Theory was the focus of a lot of Twitter backlash from Star Wars fans. But what did he say that was worthy of this response? Let's find out.
Have you seen Star Wars?
It seems like every time Theory becomes the center of attention in the Star Wars community, the fandom likes him a little bit less and less, and we see that play out in real time just this last week when Theory put out a tweet in reference to the Kenobi series. And the tweet goes, "One of the only things I want from the Obi-Wan show is Anakin Order 66 Jedi Temple flashbacks. Skywalker just destroying Jedi Padawans, Knights, Masters with ease. That's my only gripe with Revenge of the Sith. I want to see the Chosen One go ballistic. Do not hesitate, show no mercy."
You know, it's a film for 12-year-olds.
And after this tweet, basically everyone made fun of him for a few days. Since it does kind of sound like a fan fiction of a 12-year-old boy playing Battlefront 2. And because of that, a lot of people started teasing him about it, just basically joking that he wants to see more poor children be killed by Anakin because of that scene that we had with him and the younglings in Revenge of the Sith. We already had a big hint that he was murking them kids. So later, Theory kind of backtracks and says the only people saying that he wants to see kids die are people trying to fit their narrative about him. I mean, that's... even though he literally puts Padawans as the first thing that he wants to see Anakin slaughter, and Padawans are often teenagers, like Ahsoka, who was 14 at the time of the Clone Wars, and I don't know about you guys, but I would say a 14-year-old Padawan, still a kid. Also not a big fan of pulling the victim card. You know, if you get called out for, you know, a kind of just bad tweet or just something that people found stupid, doesn't mean you're a victim. I'm sorry. I don't think the real problem here is that Theory wants to see kids dying at the hands of Anakin. I think there are really only two problems with this tweet. One is he's trying to get a show about Obi-Wan Kenobi to have flashbacks of a scene that literally has nothing to do with Obi-Wan Kenobi or his show or the story at all. Also, the biggest problem with this tweet is that it shows exactly why sometimes it's not the best to listen to fans about what we should see in Star Wars. But we all know Star Wars as a family-friendly franchise. It does have its dark moments, which Revenge of the Sith is already full of. I mean, it's rated PG-13. I think it's the only Star Wars movie that has that rating. But why would any Star Wars director or creator want to put something that adds nothing to the story or the plot? What does Anakin slaughtering a bunch of Padawans, Jedi Knights, and Masters have to do with the story of Revenge of the Sith, or mainly the Obi-Wan Kenobi series? It has nothing to do with it. It's just some fantasy Theory has, which is fine. We all have Star Wars ideas in our heads and stuff we'd want to see in the movies, but, you know, most of us know deep down that some of these things are just fan fiction. You cannot, on one hand, act like you're a huge George Lucas purist and you only like the Star Wars content from George Lucas because he's the creator, he's the savior, he's our god, but then on the other hand, completely contradict what George Lucas teaches about Star Wars and how he tells stories. My friend on Instagram, Plo Cool, make sure you subscribe to him if you don't, made a great comparison of these two quotes. Here's the quote from George Lucas, and it says, "Well, when I said I was going to do the prequels, everybody said, 'That's great, we get to see Darth Vader kill everybody.' And I said, 'That's not the story.'" Compare that to what Theory was tweeting, and you have two completely different approaches to Star Wars. On one hand, you have the kind of base level of what Star Wars is. It's lightsabers and blasters and action, and it looks really, really cool, but that really only appeals to kids under the age of 13 without any taste or knowledge of cinema and storytelling. But then you have a deeper meaning of telling the story of a fallen knight who was meant to restore balance to the universe, but lost his way and betrayed everyone and everything he held dear in the name of love. Lightsabers, blasters, spaceships, and the big boom booms in the sky are all really cool. It can bring out some of the most fun Star Wars movie moments. But that's not what you're supposed to take home with you. That's not the message or the story in Star Wars. You're supposed to remember the story and the characters, the deeper meaning of seeking that destiny in life, maybe seeing our hero going from an innocent boy to the most evil man in the universe, or seeing the Jedi Order fall to the evil Sith because of their blindness and arrogance. So when you watch this scene with Anakin and the younglings at the temple, normally you're supposed to go, "Oh my god, how dark. Anakin is pure evil and has completely turned to Darth Vader." What you're not supposed to do is watch the scene where he kills younglings and go, "Bro, that's so cool, kill the Padawans next, man." Now, before you say Star Wars only, don't you think Twitter's just being a little harsh to Star Wars Theory? He was just saying that he thought it would be cool. You're right, you're absolutely right. Twitter and the internet can be harsh, and this is nothing to really be upset about or outrage. And To be fair, I don't think really anyone is outraged, thankfully. There's no big online movement of cancel Star Wars Theory for what he said. Just a bunch of people who teased Star Wars Theory for his take that a lot of people found kind of out of left field and honestly just kind of stupid. I mean, it really just seems like entry-level Star Wars fan fiction. It seems like day by day the Star Wars community is losing faith with Star Wars Theory, but more importantly, losing faith in itself. I think there's a lot of frustration and animosity in the fandom these days, and it seems like we've really gotten to a point in the Star Wars fandom where the fans don't even like the content creators and influencers in the fandom anymore. I mean, Theory used to be looked at as like a positive person in the Star Wars community, but since like 2018, people have started liking him less and less, and that's happened with almost every other influencer and content creator in the Star Wars community, except for a select few. We've really become tribalistic in this community, and it's kind of sad. I mean, hopefully when the new shows and movies begin releasing again, the fandom can stop hating its fellow Star Wars fans and just enjoy the best parts about Star Wars. Which don't include killing kids. But tell me your thoughts in the comment section below. How stupid was Theory's tweet, or do you actually agree with him and think this scene with Anakin would be cool? Tell me your thoughts below. Thank you all for watching. If you like this video, please give it a like or a comment because it does help out the channel. If you enjoy Star Wars only, become an Only fan and subscribe to the channel to stay up to date on the latest news in Star Wars. I'm Star Wars Only. I will see you all next time, and may the Force be with you always.